वेलकम बैक टू माई चैनल फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज सोनिया हियर। थैंक यू सो 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 मच फॉर ज्वाइनिंग इन। नाउ आई होप नाउ बाई दिस टाइम यू गाइज नो दैट बिफोर स्टार्टिंग माई वीडियो यू नीड टू ग्रैब अ कप ऑफ कॉफी सो दैट यू कैन एन्जॉय दिस वीडियो। ओके, नाउ हियर आई एम डूइंग अ कटरी स्टैंड टुडे। नाउ दिस इज एक्चुअली आई एम मेकिंग फॉर माई मामा एंड शी हैड बीन आस्किंग मी टू गेट अ कटरी स्टैंड फॉर हर एंड मेक इट एंड आई एम सुपर लेट फॉर दिस बिकॉज आई बिन लाइक हाँ हाँ मम्मा मैं बना दूंगी मतलब बहुत टाइम से चल रहा है। सो फाइनली आई एम मेकिंग दिस फॉर माई मॉम एंड हियर व्हाट आई एम डूइंग इज आई एम यूजिंग माई चॉक पेंट एंड आई एम यूजिंग माई अनुकूल ब्रश एंड आई एम यूजिंग दिस ऑन माई कंप्लीट पेस। नाउ टू स्टार्ट विथ आई एम नॉट यूजिंग जेसो हेयर एट ऑल एंड हेयर वाई आई डिड नॉट यूज माई जेसो इज बिकॉज आई वॉन्टेड टू डू अ बिट ऑफ सैंडिंग वर्क। हाउ एंड वाई दैट यू विल सी लेटर ऑन इन दिस वीडियो, बट नाउ जस्ट टू इन्फॉर्म यू आई एम डूइंग माई चॉक पेंट एंड आई एम गोइंग टू डू ओनली ऑन द आउटर साइड्स। आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू डू एनी वर्क ऑन द इनर साइड्स ऑफ द बॉक्स। आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू यूज माई वॉर्निश फॉर दैट। नाउ I am using my brush because I wanted it to look a little rustic. I did not want it a very plain smooth surface because when I do my lot of technique work on the top of it, it should look like a very nice and rusty project. I did not want it to have or to look it like a very finished one because that's what I thought of doing and creating with this cutlery stand. So I'm going to repeat this process of coloring on all the four sides. At the bottom, usually I do black paint color. I really don't know why. I do not have any specific reason to it, but I love using my black color gesso at the base of any of the boxes or the tray or the cutlery stand or anything. If it has a base which is not visible, I always do my black color gesso. Now here, just to give it a little more dramatic look, on the top of the edges, I'm going to have the same acrylic, same chalk paint. And yes, you need to make sure that it has to be very, very neat and clean. So yeah, take a little bit of color and do it in patch wise. And that's how I do it. So I take one area at a time and then I color it. Now this takes a little time, but please do make sure that you cover the upper wala border of the stands or the box with the colors because they look really good. Now when I do this box, I'm going to let it dry for a good amount of time. Now to save my time, I'm going to use my heat gun and with that it is going to dry out really fast. Now before we move on to the next step, the first layer of my color should be dried out completely. Now here, as I mentioned, I will be doing sanding work, so that's the reason I need to make sure that I just apply one shade of color so that I do not have to sand it too much. Secondly, it should dry out, and with just one coat of sanding, with just one coat of coloring, my sanding work will be much, much, much more easier. So here I am done with my coloring work and yes, this looks very nice. I really love this color. I absolutely love this color. So usually when we say cutlery stand, either they are in red, brown, orange, pink, but I thought of this purple shade is going to look quite different. And that was the reason I picked up this color. So yes, whatever the supplies I'm using in this video tutorial are mentioned in the video description box. You can check that. I'm also mentioning my website link, please do check and let me know which one is your favorite supply from our store. So once I'm done with this coloring work, like I mentioned, I'm going to use my heat gun to dry this up so that it speeds up the process of drying. And once this dries out, then we are moving on to the sanding part. Now here you can see me using my heat gun. Now there is a technique of using your heat guns. You should always use this from a bit of distance. Do not just bring it very closer to your surface where you are working. Especially like here I'm using it on just my chalk paints, but you have any other surfaces where you have done a lot of texture work, then it's better to keep it at a good distance of at least 6 to 8 inches. Now here with the sandpaper, I'm going to do the sanding work, and I usually take up small pieces of sandpaper and I just keep on scrubbing it off wherever I want it. So here you can see, and I'm so glad that in my this tutorial I was able to capture this part, because usually otherwise because of the lighting effects it does not come out really well. But here I can show you that how you can do the sanding on the edges and on the center part. Now one of the very important tip is that whenever you are doing your sanding work on the flat surface, like not on the edges, on the flat base surface. You always should do it in one direction so that you get that kind of look and feel. It's not that you cannot do it on any of the directions, you can, but if you want to go for something like a symmetrical kind of thing, then please rub it off only in one direction. Now this is looking super awesome. Actually, I could have just done the stamping one and this should have been ready, but I have some more amazing supplies and I just felt that adding a little more supplies is going to add a little more drama to my project. So here, this is a very important tip. Use your sandpapers in small pieces and do it in one direction so that whatever the surface you get looks really good. Now honestly, when we do sanding, I generally do not like this process because it you will end up having so much of dust on your table, and I hate cleaning my table every now and then while making the video, although I try to be as clean as possible, but it is not that easy. So yes, now in this video you will see that why, after doing the sanding work, how much dust was there on my table. I literally had to clean it twice just to make sure that everything has cleaned up properly. So I'm going to repeat the process of the sanding work on all the sides wherever I have done the chalk paints, only on the sides, not on the top part, because those are the parts which I just want to have a little darker shade. I don't want to do any of the sanding work on the upper part. Now if you want to have any of the sanding tools, you can try that also, and do let me know in the comment section which sanding paper or tool you really like the most and which you prefer to use on your projects. Now this is what the dust I was talking about. Now this is phase one of cleaning, and then immediately I have to just dust everything, my organizer, my cutlery stand, and then what I got was the second layer of dust. And yes, you need to clean your table really well. Now it's time to do my stencil work, and this is one of the very beautiful and versatile stencil, and I'm using my stencil brushes here. Now whenever I do my stencil work, I usually try to remove all the excessive color. So here I'm using my acrylic blocks. I absolutely love the idea of having acrylic blocks because it saves so much of time in cleaning your table mats. Every time you just need to take your small piece of acrylic block and clean it up. Now here I'm going to do this in patchwork. So wherever I've done the sanding work, I'm not going to do my stencil work there because I want to highlight my sanding part, and that you will see that how I'm highlighting and that how it is popping out so well with so much of layer of work and detailing. So yes, usually I love using the contrast colors. So like I said, I have taken up the purple for the base, so I'm taking this tinge of pink. Now you must be wondering, acha purple pe to itna pink kar diya, but so pink is more highlighting? No, because the kind of work I had decided on, like I mentioned earlier, the pink is not going to pop out that much. So this is the one of the great ideas of blending your colors with different mediums. Like, it's not that every time you need to play around with the colors only. You can use your decoupage papers, transfer papers, your gift wrapping papers or newspaper, any kind of mediums to do the color blending and just highlight your work the way you want it. So here I'm almost done with my stencil work, and please, for this step, please do make sure that you take just a tinge of color and rub this very well on your surface. So here I am done with my stencil work completely, and this dries up very, very quickly, so I don't have to spend a lot of time here. Now this is one of the Insta transfer sheets, and I'm going to just measure this, that how much is required for one of the sides. Now as you can see, the my cutlery stand is a little bigger than my transfer sheet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut this into smaller pieces. Yes, you heard me right. Honestly, it took me so much of guts to cut this paper because this print is absolutely gorgeous. This is one of my favorite, but I wanted to use this in not the typical way, in a different and a very different look and feel. I wanted to give this to my project. So here what I'm going to do is now I'm going to cut this into smaller patches. Now just because it has margins at the back, it was easier for me to cut it in a straight line. I did not have to use any of my trimmer or scales or pencils or mark anything, nothing. I was just following these lines and I was cutting it. So I just took it off approximately 1.5 inches, approximately. I don't remember the exact sizes. Size does not matter here. It depends on what kind of surface you are working for and what kind of space you have for the design. Accordingly, you can decide it. Now, once I'm done with the cutting work of the half sheet, then I'm going to do it for the other half sheet. And once I'm happy with that, then we are going to stick this on our base. Now this is super fun process. Just take any of your cotton cloth or your sponge or your sponge dab or any piece of surface. Even you can use a paintbrush. Just tap it on the surfaces wherever you are using your sheets. Once you are done with that, let it soak in all the water for say 10 seconds or 15 seconds and then you can remove it. So initially when I started doing these kind of sheets, I was like doing one sheet and then I used to wait like one part, then I used to wait for the other, for that one to dry out, come out really well and then do it. But later on I realized even if you keep it for a little more time, it's absolutely fine, so that you can just stick everything where whatever you want, soak it in water and then you can start removing it quickly. So here I'm using my brush to just make sure that I stick this well. If there are any bubbles or wrinkles out there, I can just remove it with my brushes. But even if you don't do that, just press it with your fingers and it will be done. So now it's time to seal it up. Why we need to seal it up? Because this needs to seal up very well before we do the next layer of work, whatever we want to do here. Now once I do my varnish work, I'm going to let it dry for at least half an hour and then we will be moving on to the next step. Now when I'm doing my varnish work here, I will also make sure that I cover up all the parts wherever I have done the chalk paints. Now if you want, you can do the varnish work on your inner side there at that time only, but otherwise you can chuck that. Now it's time for massive stamping, and for massive stamping I'm using my permanent ink pad, and on all the patches I'm going to use this checkered stamp. Now this is one of my favorite stamp, and I'm so glad that massive brand gave me this opportunity to use this stamp, because they are so versatile. I have used these stamps with chalk paints, with gliding adhesives and whatnot, and they are still so good. So yeah, here I'm doing my stamping work. Once that is done, then I'm going to repeat the same process on the upper side also, just to add a little more drama. So stamping is one of the best technique to add a little more drama to your project, a little more elements to your project. Now once you're done with your stamping work, please do not forget to seal it up, even if it's a permanent ink what we had used, but it is very important to seal them. So here I'm using my varnish again. You can try out different varnishes. I'll share a couple of links down in the video description box where you can check like what all other varnishes you can use. Also, just in case if you have not checked my video on various types of varnishes available in the market, please do check that. It works out so well. So here I'm going to cover my inner side of my cutlery stand with a varnish, and I'll make sure that I cover this up really well. And I'm going to have good 2-3 coats of varnish inside also, so that this can be used for a longer run. The cleaning becomes much more easier. So here is the fun part. Here I'm using a dye based ink pad. This is orange color, and this is just, I'm going to rub it on wherever I had done the sanding part. In fact, I'm going to rub it on my complete surface. So what happens is, when you use your dye based ink pads, it is not a permanent ink pad. It is going to smudge. So what I do is, I use my ink pad on the edges. It adds a nice that dramatic color to it, and then I let it dry for half an hour or 1 hour, and then I'll do my varnish. But here is a tip: whenever you are letting them dry and we are using your varnish, do not overdo the varnish. Just one coat of varnish, then again let it dry for 2 hours, and then do your second coat of varnish. So I actually did this varnish work after half an hour, and once I was done with the first coat of varnish, then I did my second coat of varnish after 2 hours. So once you learn this technique of quick dye based ink pad using in your mixed media projects or your decoupage or your transfer projects, you will realize that you need so many less supplies, and with just few elements you can add a lot more drama to your projects. So yes, I know on video it is not very much visible that how the orange colors has popped out, but they looked really awesome. So I really hope that you all enjoyed this tutorial. Just in case if you guys has not subscribed to my channel, please do that, and thank you. Take care. Bye bye.